Hey there, fellow coders! Welcome back to another exciting episode of Coding with TD. In our previous episode, we laid the foundation for our PDF invoice template by establishing a grid layout and incorporating a sleek watermark feature. If you missed it, be sure to check it out for valuable insights and practical demonstrations. Now, we're ready to pick up where we left off and continue our journey towards building the ultimate automated invoicing solution. So, without further ado, let's dive right back into the action and explore the next text box in our template design. To ensure clarity and professionalism, let's include a footnote text box at the bottom of our invoice template. Here, we can add essential information such as payment terms, contact details, or any other relevant notes for the recipient. Another crucial element of any invoice is the inclusion of bank details for payment. Let's create a dedicated text box to display this information prominently on our template, making it easy for clients to process payments efficiently. Thank you. For internal tracking and administrative purposes, it's helpful to have a designated area on the invoice for office use. Here, we can add reference numbers, order codes, or any other information relevant to our internal processes. A well-designed header title can instantly elevate the professionalism of our invoice. Let's create a sleek text box at the top of our template to display the invoice title or company name in a bold and eye-catching font. Next, let's add a section for the sender's details, the invoice from information.
This includes the name, address, and contact details of our company or organization, ensuring clarity and transparency in our communications.
Oops, I made a boo-boo here. Please ignore the written statement about the invoice details text box. In the invoice details text box, we provide essential information such as the invoice date, invoice number, and any tax numbers related to the invoice. This section helps ensure that all necessary details are clearly presented and easily accessible to both the sender and the recipient.
As mentioned earlier, this section for the sender's details, the invoice from information. This includes the name, address, and contact details of our company or organization, ensuring clarity and transparency in our communications. Similarly, we'll create a section for the recipient's details, the invoice to information.
This includes the name, address, and contact details of the client or customer receiving the invoice.
To provide further clarity on the products or services rendered, we'll include a dedicated section for a detailed description. Here, we can use tables to present information such as item names, descriptions, quantities, rates, and totals in a clear and concise format. And there you have it, fellow coders. With our PDF template now beautifully crafted, we're ready to move on to the next phase of our automation journey. In the upcoming videos, we'll delve into the exciting world of data extraction from MS Excel files. We'll learn how to seamlessly integrate this data into our Python script, populating the variables to generate customized invoices effortlessly. But wait, there's more. We'll explore the power of for loops to automate the generation of multiple invoices, streamlining our workflow and saving valuable time. And finally, we'll tackle the last piece of the puzzle, email automation. We'll discover how to attach each invoice to an email and send it directly to the recipient, completing the invoicing process with finesse. So, stay tuned for these forthcoming episodes packed with invaluable insights and practical demonstrations. Remember to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you don't miss out on any of the action. Until next time, happy coding! TD.